It is not by chance that I became a teacher, but by choice. That is a connection and a bond that is built while teaching and learning.
Hello and a very warm welcome to Great Principles. I am Seema Choria. I bring to you another iconic figure from the world of Indian academia, Mrs. Sheila Alexander, Principal, Good Shepherd International School, Ooty, the Nilgiris, Tamil Nadu. The famous American educator, author, businessman, and keynote speaker, Stephen Covey, said, and I quote, "We are the creative force of our life. And through our own decisions rather than our conditions, if we carefully learn to do the things, we can accomplish those goals." My guest today made that choice long, long time ago and achieved everything she set out to do, become an educator, bring focus and competence to the noble vocation she is so passionate about. Join me in welcoming Mrs. Sheila Alexander, Principal of Good Shepherd School, Ooty. Welcome to Great Principles, ma'am. It's an honor to have you here.
Thank you so much, Seema. It's my pleasure too.
So, ma'am, let us start our conversation by knowing from where it all started. Once upon a time, you wanted to become an educator. You have achieved much more than that today. Today, you are a role model for so many aspiring educators out there. We would like to know from you, is it only the subject matter that matters to be an educator, or you need to require much more than this to be effective?
Seema, it was my childhood dream to be a teacher. I was inspired by my teachers and I followed my passion. It is not by chance that I became a teacher, but by choice. And when I did my schooling, graduation, my elders, my mom used to ask me, "What you would like to be when you grow up?" I used to tell, "I would like to be a teacher." And I achieved my dreams, completed my post-graduation, and immediately did my bachelor's in education. And I topped the college for my bachelor's in education because I love teaching. And teaching is at the core of my heart. And even if I get a chance now, I will pick up a book and I will go to my class and I will teach, because I feel that is the best way to connect with your students. And I tell my teachers also, a student will love your subject if they love your subject, if they love the teacher. It is the teacher that makes the difference, and they will score the grades that will be excellent only if they like the subject and like the teacher. That is the connection and the bond that is built while teaching and learning. So I became a teacher in 1987. I came to Good Shepherd as a young bride, newly married, and my husband was working here, and taught sciences, biology, and within a few years, I was promoted to the deputy headmistress of Good Shepherd International School in 1998. And after that, I rose up in my professional career as the headmistress, then the Dean of Academics, IBDP coordinator and vice principal. And in 2014, as a senior vice principal. And in 2020, when my founder principal of Good Shepherd International School passed away, I had to step into his shoes. I was appointed as a principal of Good Shepherd International School after he passed away on June 16, 2020. That is my professional journey.
Absolutely, ma'am. You know, when a teacher who has chosen this profession by choice, when she speaks, she always speaks, you know, the passion for which she has chosen this. And that is when a teacher is passionate, she can make a child fall in love with the subject, as you rightly said. So it's not only about the academic knowledge, it's also about connecting with the students that is required. A teacher needs to connect to the students, as ma'am rightly said. So to all my dear teachers out there, the connection is very much required. Going ahead in our conversation, ma'am, I would like to know from you, there are many parents out there, those who do not know the exact advantages or, you know, the exact difference of being in a residential school and in a day school. So how is residential schooling different to the regular one or the, you know, schooling patterns for teachers and students? What are your opinions on this?
Being in a residential school from 1987 and GSIS being one of the top school in India, and we've been ranked as number one boarding school, especially in fully residential school categories, because even our staff children stay in the boarding. And the advantages of residential school is GSIS, especially I can speak about GSIS because I was only in GSIS. GSIS is a community by itself. We have a community of caring, compassionate individuals living together with harmony, peace, and very responsible and caring for each other. And because it's a community and because we are fully residential, we are self-sufficient, we are available, and it's an extended family atmosphere that is experienced at all times. You're there for your children. As I told, the bond is there, the connection is there, your children are there at all times. And by doing so, we ensure that our children transform into responsible children, and where we nurture and develop their talents. Because Guchappar International School does not believe only in excelling in academics. We integrate the co-curricular, extracurricular activities into a regular schedule and giving more importance to performing and creative arts. And we have a range of subjects offered, and our 150-acre campus and the hill station in Nilgiris, and the state-of-the-art infrastructure that is available speaks volume about what our children will be when they pass out of the portals of Guchappar International School. There's a bond, there's a connection, and where the potential of the children is always kindled to reach to its full potential. That is what we do in Guchappar International School.
Certainly, that's what makes it as a top school of India, no doubt about it. So ma'am, tell me one thing, what is the right age for a child to be admitted in a residential school?
See, as far as age is concerned, if the child is willing, if the parents are willing, if the extended family, grandparents are willing, that is a decision that the parents take. We accept children from grade 3 onwards, and we require that complete willingness on the part of the parents and the child to join a residential school. And once a child joins our school, the child becomes a part of Guchappar International School. And there are children, some of the children who love to stay back even during the holidays so that they can enjoy being part of Guchappar International School. But definitely children like to go back home also during their holidays, because that is a different atmosphere back at home.
So ma'am, here, you know, there is one more doubt which our viewers almost have, that when a child is in residential school, he has an advantage of staying that extra hours, you know, 24/7 he's there. So what is that additional ability which is being developed in a residential school, which parents are not able to see the difference in a day school?
See, Children are there with us 24/7. We know the children. We know what their talents are. We can identify them, nurture them, and develop them. And we can make students be responsible, independent, and critical thinkers because they live with us. Like how we know our own children very well, the same is in the case of Guchappan International School, because our students and staff community live together. It is not that the students are in boarding and the staff come from outside. We have a community. Right now, we have 300 and only grades. We have reopened only for grades 9 to 12. We have around 326 students on campus. We are around 350 staff staying on campus, academic, co-curricular, support staff, administrative staff to take care of the children. So the advantage is they can nurture, they can build on their passion, whatever it is, be it in the field of music, dance, sports and games. They can build on that because they have the extra hours. Our teachers also, because they stay on campus, are available for the students, like at home, to connect with the with their children. And we have a system where we have a tutor ward meeting, or it is otherwise called advisor advisee meeting, where each teacher is assigned with a set of children who will know everything about the child, and this child will share with the teacher if the child requires any support in any areas, any personal, social, physical, or any part of the student's development. And one thing about GSIS, the well-being of the child is the core of our residential school. And we give a lot of importance to that.
Wow, you know, ma'am, hearing you, I truly believe that every parent dream of making their children to be responsible, independent, and creative thinker. That is what we all want. So I truly believe that, yes, everyone should have a, you know, certain years for their children to be spent in residential school. That truly creates a difference. As ma'am mentioned, it's, you know, family away from family. So a big family wherein children are getting to learn to be independent and harnessing their, honing their skills also. Being a creative thinker and following their passions, what more can a child expect at this age? So wonderful to know the concept of residential schooling, and wonderful to know how Guchappan International School is working around and building responsible citizens for our country. Going ahead, ma'am, in the past few decades, education has witnessed a paradigm shift with the pedagogies and holistic approaches speaking in. So which of the recent pedagogies actually would equally benefit all stakeholders?
We have a many different kind of pedagogy approaches because we do the IB curriculum, we do the Cambridge, we do the national curriculum, which all believes in inquiry-based approach, constructivist approach, integrated approach, collaborative approach. There are different pedagogies available, but the learner is the center of all these pedagogies. And as long as the learning is meaningful and the teachers are leaders in learning, they should be the leaders in learning. And when learning is made meaningful and students enjoy the process of learning, then the learning impact is very evident. So we are not looking at learning outcomes or learning objectives. We are looking at learning impacts, where the skills that they achieve or the conceptual knowledge that they achieve during their schooling in Guchappan International School becomes a part of their lifelong learning and develop transferable skills, which can be nurtured further in any profession or any environment they choose to develop in. And as a result, we believe in developing global citizens, especially when the situation right now is uncertain, unpredictable, preparing them for that is our goal.
I think this was an amazingly wonderful answer, because ma'am has not pointed out in any pedagogy. She believes that if the learning is meaningful, then the pedagogy is actually the best pedagogy suited. And teachers has to be at the learners. They have to be a lifelong learner so that they can impart the knowledge. So this is a very beautiful answer here. I really love the part where you said that, you know, every learning should be impactful and it should be able to help children develop their skills and utilize those skills in future. So wonderful answer by ma'am here. Going ahead, ma'am. Ma'am, your journey has been over decades and you have many followers and you are a role model for many, I'm sure. I would like to ask you, name one educator who is your role model or inspiration.
My role model is Dr. P.C. Thomas, the founder principal of Good Shepherd International School. Along with him, I have Mrs. Elsima Thomas, the co-founder of Good Shepherd International School, as my role model. Because they are institution builders and they have made a difference in the education sector and also the service sector. And I'm happy and with pride, I will say that I had the opportunity to walk along with the founder principal and as a result, the changes, the transformation that he brought into the education sector is evident in Good Shepherd International School, and he has mentored me. And I take pride in that, and also Mrs. Elsima Thomas, who's the co-founder and the managing trustee of Good Shepherd International School. I've learned a lot from both of them, and sir is my role model and will be my role model too.
Wonderful. You know, when you spend so many years in an institution, each and every person there, you know, starts inspiring you, the atmosphere, the environment, you become the part of it. And that is what is with ma'am. She is fortunate enough to work with the founders, to work with them. And that is how today she is. She is also having the same meaning, same vision with her of transforming education, creating a difference. Wonderful, ma'am. On this note, we reach to the very interesting segment of the show, which is called Rapid Fire Round. You have to answer in one word or a single statement. Here goes the first question. You spend your recreational time indulging in activities like?
I love reading and learning, anything connected to education.
All right, great. If offered a choice to spend time, you would rather learn a new language, a new dish, or a new technology?
I would rather go to a class and start teaching something different from what you asked.
All right. That's a two teacher speaking from her heart, because, you know, once a teacher, you're always a teacher. The best thing you love to do is to teach. Next question. Your favorite regional staple food is?
Dosas.
Dosas. Filter coffee or Nescafe? What is your elixir?
Filter coffee.
Your favorite Kollywood actor is?
One thing is, I don't see movies at all. If you ask me about any cricket players or I would answer. Hollywood, I like Surya.
All right, you like Surya, great. And who is your favorite sports person?
Definitely Dhoni.
Dhoni, no doubt about it. A very calm and cool captain Indian history has ever seen.
Yes.
So this brings to me to the last question of the show, which is called viewer's choice question. It was absolutely fun knowing you in the rapid fire section. So we got to know that what ma'am does in her free time. Now our viewers have a lot of questions coming up, and this one we have picked up for you. With the launch of National Education Policy 2020, many parents and students are looking for some intelligible answers to the question it has raised about subject selection and future impact on careers. So what do you think? Do you believe this policy is one for the long run, or it is a temporary part of educational reform?
It is. The National Education Policy is the need of the hour, because I believe, and that is what Dr. Thomas, 45 years before, when he founded Good Shepherd International School, he had already integrated all the extracurricular, co-curricular, liberal arts, creative and performing arts languages into our school curriculum. And it is required because students can pick and choose their subjects as per the interest. And only thing that we require in a country like India, we need to also give a lot of importance to teacher education too, because unlearning and relearning should be done by the teachers. We need to nurture them, and a lot of professional development has to happen. Because this is an entirely a different approach to education. So to teach and bring up this to the required standard, we require educators. So teaching them first and bringing them to the classroom is the need of the hour, and that is much required for a country like India to have education that is current and which is per the needs or the requirement or the interests of the students. And that is very, very important.
Certainly, you know, to deliver the content we require, amazing teachers, a 21st century educator can only develop 21st century children. Talking about the teaching quality, ma'am, I have, you know, one doubt here. When every day we are seeing new startups coming up, Whitehead Junior is there, Byju's is there, Unacademy is there. They are picking up the teachers from our own system. They are training them and claiming that, you know, that we have the best teachers out there. So where are we failing as institutions, as government? Aren't we training our teachers well? And how come these startups are doing it?
See, I will tell you, when the pandemic happened in 2020, we had large buildings, we have a lot of infrastructure, we had schools with ACs, a lot of buses, but our learning and teaching continued. It only happened because of our teachers. Our teachers, from traditional in-person teaching, they transitioned into teachers teaching remotely and virtually. See, the teachers have the power within themselves to transition and to learn. So anybody who is being provided with the right professional development can rise up to the required standard and changes in the field of education. These startups have trained. We also believe in training. And a teacher is one person who has a growth mindset. Unless the teacher has a growth mindset, she cannot develop that in her students, because her students are much ahead and they are learning in an environment in which it is a different generation itself that we are facing. So unless the teachers are ready, prepared and fully competent, we cannot achieve that. Our teachers are competent, our teachers are capable, and our teachers ran the show when everything came to a standstill. Big kudos to our teachers, and so that to ensure, and because of our teachers, learning never stopped. Even though there might be slight gaps, that gaps can be plugged in or it can be covered once the children come back, but it did not come to a standstill. It is because of our teachers.
So true, ma'am. You know, teachers came out as an unsung heroes during this pandemic, and they are the only one because of whom the learning had continued. And I really like the point where you spoke that, you know, teachers have huge potential. It's up to us how we unleash that. So as you rightly said, these startups understood that potential and they gave the right training, and there where teachers are shining. So I think if government take up this, the institutes take up this, you know, treating their teacher well, training them, so every teacher will be the best educator out there, giving out their best. So very beautifully and honest answer given by ma'am here, that it's we who are not giving the right training to the teachers and where they are lacking. I really like the point where you said, you know, that teachers have huge potential. It's we who are not identifying that and training them. And these startups knew that. Every teacher has huge potential and you can train them. They are ready to unlearn, relearn, yes. Learn. So that is where the whole magic lies. So it was an amazing session having you here, knowing about the best residential school of the country. And ma'am, you know, you had brought peace in my mind today that while educators like you are at the helm of learning in India, students and teachers surely are going to reap success in their lives. So it was so wonderful to know this amazing school. It was so wonderful to know ma'am, who is a true teacher at heart. We at Great Principles feel privileged to have an opportunity to interact with you. We thank you for your time with us. It was truly an insightful session. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, Seema, for the opportunity.